Biohacker Season 1 is one of those fun shows where the cold open is a scene that actually occurs towards the end of the season's timeline. So most of the events of Season 1 are the lead up to that scene, and then there's the twist ending. Let's recap what we learned from Season 1. One of the main characters is Professor Tanya Lawrence. Her goal was to patent something very special in order to drastically change the world. Lawrence's goal was to effectively make humans immune from all genetic disorders and disease. And she'd monetize that. The other main character is Emma. Emma's family died when she was young, so she was raised in Sweden by her grandmother. And Emma goes by a new name, Mia Åkerlund, in order to keep her true identity secret. Mia had a twin brother, Ben. But as children, Professor Lawrence experimented on her, Ben, and 235 other children, Project Homo Deus. Mia was the only child to survive the project, and as a result, Mia's blood is very special. She never gets sick. But the experiment came at a cost. Her brother died from the project. During her brother's funeral, Mia heard her father yelling at Lawrence. Her father tried to bring evidence of Project Homo Deus to an unnamed journalist, but Lawrence chased him. Mia's father crashed the car, and both he and Mia's mother died. But Mia survived. When Lawrence walked up to the car and grabbed the confidential information about Mia's brother, Mia played possum. So basically, Mia grew up and her goal is to take down Lawrence. The first step was for Mia to attend the university that Lawrence teaches at. Then, Mia proved to be a special student. She got Lawrence to accept her as a student assistant. And so, she got access to Lawrence's labs. And by chance, Mia also started dating Lawrence's closest assistant, Jasper. One of Lawrence's subjects bailed on his study, so Lawrence asked Mia for her saliva. That was bad news because Mia's biometric data would have revealed that she was really Emma Engels, the lone survivor of Project Homo Deus. So Mia changed her sample with a sample of her roommate, Lotta. Unfortunately, Mia put the label on upside down, so Jasper was suspicious that something had happened. Later, Mia conned her way into Lawrence's house by saying that she had to go potty. Jasper had a health emergency, so Mia called Nicholas over to help. At the end, Mia printed out documents for Project Homo Deus, but she ran out of time, so she left evidence in the printer. Luckily for her, Nicholas had gone to the bathroom, and he noticed that something was strange when Mia and Lawrence walked out, so he secretly went into the study and retrieved the rest of the documents. That helped keep Mia's mission a secret for the time being. Mia and Nicholas then discussed her true past, and then went to a nursing home and asked Dr. Arnold Schumann about Project Homo Deus, since his initials identified him as the lab technician of the project. Dr. Schumann told Mia that the children in the experiment were not born with genetic disorders. Lawrence had intentionally mutated the embryos and then experimented on them with a gene therapy that had previously worked on animals. Unfortunately, it didn't work on any of the children, except for Mia. Meanwhile, Lawrence had seen the glow-in-the-dark party stuff on Mia, and later, Lawrence saw the glow-in-the-dark party stuff on her router, so Lawrence became suspicious of Mia. Previously, Lawrence had just chalked up Mia's biometric data as being flawed, but at this point, she realized that Mia may have switched out her DNA with someone else's DNA. So Lawrence told Jasper to keep his eye on Mia, as she might be working with the Ethics Commission. Speaking of Jasper, Jasper's situation was unique. Jasper has Huntington's disease and relies on Lawrence to keep him alive. On top of that, Jasper's connection to Lawrence allows him to research the disease in hopes of a cure. So Jasper is thankful for that help and he is very loyal to Lawrence. Jasper found a bunch of documents about Lawrence in Mia's room, and then Mia admitted to him that she had swapped out her DNA sample. So Jasper ran Mia's DNA from a strand of her hair and told Lawrence that Mia was spying on her. Ironically, Mia showed up to Lawrence's house right after that phone call. And right away, Mia admitted to Lawrence that she was actually Emma Engels. And to her surprise, Lawrence confirmed as much with a new sample. Lawrence was ecstatic, as it meant that Project Homo Deus had actually worked. Mia knew from Dr. Schumann that Lawrence had actually mutated their genes before the Homo Deus experiment, but she pretended that she didn't know that. Instead, Mia thanked Lawrence for saving her life in order to stay on Lawrence's good side. Mia's new goal was to find out what mutation was made to her in order to figure out who the other Homo Deus children were. But Lawrence was onto her. She saw Mia run off with their own DNA information. Chenlo helped Mia isolate the mutation while Nicholas fought Jasper and stole his access card to the Excellence Center. Mia then stole the DNA samples for the Homodeus children and got on a train to Berlin with Nicholas so as to give the information to her journalist contact. But if Mia exposed Lawrence, it would be the end of Lawrence's research. Her lab would be shut down. Since Jasper relies on Lawrence to stay alive, and since he had seen a receipt for Mia and Nicholas's train tickets in Nicholas's trash can, Lawrence had Jasper secretly board the train and release his genetically altered mosquitoes. The mosquitoes spread the Coxsackie virus, which causes people to have heart attack-like symptoms. But Mia eventually woke up, since her DNA is special. Mia escaped the train and went to Jasper's lab to create the antibodies. Jasper showed up, and Mia told him the truth about Lawrence, but Jasper did not believe her. So he destroyed his own sample of antibodies and left. But then Mia's roommate showed up, and they recreated the antibodies from the little bit that Mia was able to collect. The police showed up, but Lada pretended to be Mia, which allowed Mia to escape. Mia went to the hospital and gave the nurse the antibodies. But the antibodies didn't work, because it was a mutated virus. Lawrence's antibodies were never intended to work. Lawrence had created the problem as an opportunity to use her new gene therapy on them, Homodeus. In other words, the victims of the mosquitoes became new test subjects. And on top of that, Lawrence leveraged those victims as a way of getting Mia to come back with the Homodeus data and samples. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Jasper had gone to Lawrence's house and found out that everything Mia said was true. So he called out Lawrence. She ratted him out to the police, telling them that he let the mosquitoes loose. Jasper escaped, but Mia showed up. Mia gave Lawrence back the DNA samples in exchange for Homodeus, and she used it to heal Nicholas and the other victims. Lawrence then destroyed both the DNA and the data from Homodeus, but Jasper had already copied the data. So Jasper sent the data to Emma, and Emma finally met up with her journalist contact, who turned out to be Lawrence's old friend, Dr. Andreas Winter. When Emma gave Winter the Homodeus experiment data, he didn't use it to expose Lawrence. Instead, he captured Emma and took her hostage. And he already had Professor Lawrence hostage as well. That is how season one ended. Pretty good. Season two drops later this week. But before we go, one thing that we glossed over is that Mia suggested that her roommates find the cure to Huntington's disease since they're really smart. And Lada's family is very wealthy, so they could finance and benefit off of it. Let's hope they do, for the sake of Jasper.